to the humans. I didn't know who I was supposed to be talking to. Am I supposed to be talking to the football team? Am I supposed to be talking to the student body to get y'all packed up? So I thought about it and decided I'm going to talk to everybody. All the students in the student body, high school, junior high, do y'all believe y'all have good school spirit? That is terrible. Come on. Good school spirit is not just showing up at the pep rally and getting out of class. School spirit is showing up at the game. So I'm going to challenge every one of y'all to be at the game tonight. To be like, paint your faces, bring noise makers, do something. When our team does something good, get loud. When the other team's trying to do something good, get loud, disrupt them. Then I'm going to challenge you. I'm going to challenge you to take a picture of yourself at the game. And I want you to put it on Twitter and hashtag GSIndians and put your class next to it. The challenge is to see who has the most good pictures at the game tonight and who shows the best spirit. Next, I want to talk to the team. Y'all have an opportunity to do something that hadn't been done here in a long time. And I'm going to give you a little bit of history. 1979, Grant Spleen went 1-9. In 1980, they went 0-10. But then there was a group of guys that came through and said, you know what? We're not going to listen to what everybody else is telling us. Everybody says y'all can't win because y'all haven't been winning. They said, we're not going to listen to you. And the next 18 years, Grant Spleen went to the playoffs 15. In 18 years, 15 years. Football is the same. Right. Coming successful is hard. Staying successful is easy. Your coach and I played years after that team in '82. We played after that. It was easy for us because everybody believed we could win. But that first group in 1982, nobody believed they'd won or that they could win because they hadn't won. Last week I heard somebody say at halftime they said, at least we're not getting the ball that's better than last year. That's not acceptable. You don't look at last year. You're this year. You're a new team. You've got to believe. Second, can't make mistakes. Austin, can't make mistakes. You can't do your team any good since on the sideline. Offense, false start penalties. Your challenge tonight is to get none. That kills drives. Drives get killed, kills games. Y'all had a different outlook in the first half, and then y'all had a bunch of false starts that killed it. And finally, I want to tell you what a coach of mine in college told me. He said, guys, I don't know how when you wake up on the game day, you're not more excited than you've been ever in your life because you have an opportunity to do something that's special. I thought he was talking about winning or just playing or whatever. He said, football is a physical game, a game with contact. A game where you hit people. He said, you get the opportunity to go do things out there when you play that you're going to go to jail for if you do the rest of your life. Yeah. And if you enjoy that, this is your game. So those are the three things I'm asking you to do. Believe. Don't make mistakes. And play physical. You know, it's not always the biggest and the fastest and the strongest and the most talented teams that win. Some of those teams crater when somebody that's not as big, not as fast, not as talented, not as strong, hits them really hard. All right, now we'll turn back to the student body. There's a chant that's starting with Army's football team at the Army. And it carried over this summer to the U.S. when they were doing the soccer or whatever it was. So I want y'all to repeat after me, and I want you to be loud. Can y'all be loud? Let me know. Repeat after me. I. Louder. I believe. I believe that. I believe that we will win. I believe that we will win.